Now to a story we wanted to bring you last night, the maiden flight of a restored fighter plane that was lost to the depths of a Russian lake almost 60 years ago.
It was looping the loop like a youngster over the weekend in the company of another rebuilt fighter from the same family. Here's Michael Holland.
What I see is something gorgeous to be able to fly like that after all these years. Speed, smooth speed.
They're both World War II P-40 Kittyhawks, one 79 years old, the other 81. Then there's Laurie.
I'll be 99 in June.
Who's driven himself here to Ardmore to have his heart stirred.
It's beautiful, beautiful.
Laurie's love for the Kittyhawk stretching back 80 years when, as an RNZAF aircraft technician, he served in the Solomon Islands.
They were the prettiest of all the American aircraft. Excellent machine, very reliable and easy to work on, and definitely not temperamental.
Given his wartime association, this occasion an absolute must. The bringing together of two Kittyhawks, restored by Ardmore's pioneer Aero, and flown as a one-off by husband and wife Frank Parker and Liz Needham.
She's an absolute delight to fly. Today's pretty special, getting two Kittyhawks up together.
These guys who rebuild these things, to my mind, they're not engineers, they're artisans, and it almost boggles my mind what they do.
None more so than this just-completed P-40, which spent almost 60 years at the bottom of a Russian lake.
We're unbelievably proud. We are proud as punch of this thing. And it's an amazing feeling to be able to start the engine and go, we've done this, we've built this plane from a wreck.
It has been flown by a Russian pilot.
In an American machine?
Yep, an American machine.
Fighting the Germans.
He was shot down by a Messerschmitt 109, I believe.
There was a lot of damage from the impact with the water, and some combat damage as well.
Yet, remarkably,
there was still air pressure in the tyres.
Wow.
Wow, absolutely wow.
And not to leave the other machine out, which now flies for New Zealand warbirds, it saw action under Australian colours in New Guinea and crashed during landing.
And it just sat on the side of the airfield for 60-odd years until it was recovered and eventually rebuilt.
I see your name badge, you're plain old Frank Parker.
Uh-huh.
Your wife is First Lady.
Yeah, well, I have the honour of being President of Warbirds.
So she's the First Lady to the President of the Warbirds. To me, it's a brute. When it comes to handling?
It's a fighter. It's made to go and chase things and be manoeuvrable. And so you move the controls a little bit and the aeroplane reacts instantaneously. It's got a feel to it. You can feel the aeroplane through the control. It talks to you, and you talk to it.
We love this machine. We really do. We're proud to show it to the world. It's an amazing, amazing machine with an amazing history.
But it's beautiful. Very beautiful.